Hey, would you like a jelly baby?
Oh, thank you.
Oh, cool.
Yes, yes. Oh.
Hey.
Hello. So, yeah, just don't mind us, we're just eating jelly babies.
I have a whole packet of them.
what are we doing now, Andrew? What are we doing?
We are reviewing the first episode.
Oh, yeah.
Pilot.
Yeah, that's why you're here. So, yeah, me and Andrew are going to review the first episode of Series 10, and it's going to be an interesting one, so I hope you enjoy.
Stay tuned.
This is going to be interesting because I think we both have mixed opinions about this one.
Yeah. I mean, you, like, when we finished watching it, you were like, I really enjoyed that. That was really good.
And you're just like...
Me? I think it was quite a weak storyline.
I agree with you, it's a weak story though, but... I think I can accept that because it's just the first episode and I don't think it needs to be a whole big story arc thing.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting it to be anything big. But, you know, it was okay. It was a bit of a, oh, actually, the big watery blob thing is actually obsessed with you. She doesn't want to kill you. She's actually obsessed with you and loves you, and therefore, yeah, actually, nothing was dangerous in the first place, so it's all fine.
I think this story thing's going to continue.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, perhaps.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just I can see it wasn't that threatening though, but I would say the water creature did make me jump in a few scenes when she was in the bath, when she was going inside the bathroom.
That bit was creepy. Yeah, well, you just see the eye through the plug hole.
Yeah, I'll tell you one thing. You're going to be surprised about this. I actually enjoyed Inado. I am very surprised.
Actually.
Yeah.
I think he was a bit more serious in this one, though.
He was half and half.
He added a light touch to it, but he didn't go overboard.
No.
I like Noodle anyway. So.
Yeah, we're not forgetting what we called him. I liked it when Bill said to the doctor, "It's bigger on the inside," and then that Noodle is like, "He says we got there."
That was quite fun. Considering it took her a long time to gauge, it was bigger on the inside. She gets pretty good marks on her.
Yeah, even though that she's just she's not actually a student there. She's just.
I think there are a couple of inconsistencies there, but oh well.
I would have liked to have seen more of the doctor lecturing.
Yeah,
I mean,
to be fair, if I'm super 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 critical of it. I attend physics lectures.
you just want to...
I attend physics and mathematics lectures.
You just want to look out for Peter, don't you?
Well, they're far, far more involved than what is
Peter just said.
Is on the... Yeah.
As Bill said, the university let him do whatever he likes. Like, one time he's going to talk about physics and next minute he's talking about poetry.
Well, according to him, they're the same thing.
I also liked it.
Go on.
I liked it that he had Susan and
Shushan. I'm always gonna say
Shushan and River.
Yeah. Yeah, that was really cool.
River, yeah, that was interesting. Yeah, we had to change camera then because my camera just went...
His camera has very little memory.
Yes, I really need to
get it. So he chose mine.
So we're using Andrew's now, so hello. But anyway, as I was saying, I liked it that he had Shushan, a picture on his desk, but I don't really see why he had a picture of River on, because, yeah, I can understand that. That the Doctor wants to remember River, but I don't think we needed to see it. What do you think?
I think that, I mean, I don't think it... I'm not that worked up in the fact that I saw it. I was quite happy to have seen it. It's quite nice that River is remembered, you know. Honestly, I'm completely for it. Obviously, you know, okay, Susan and River are two very important people in the Doctor's life, which is fair enough to have those there, but why not some other people? You know, I mean, you could obviously choose plenty other examples of people that he would have pictures of, you know, but I mean, the fact that he chose those two, Susan and, it was quite nice to have that kind of shout back.
I thought
it was quite nice to have that kind of shout out to the classic era.
Yeah.
With Susan on, which obviously, like, most people watching the modern series wouldn't understand.
Yeah.
But it was
I think, well, as you just said, there's no, because you know, people to our age or younger don't really watch the classics, though, but we do, though, because I love the classics. I thought it was really nice that we got a reference from Susan, and the First Doctor just said these particular words, and he hasn't promised them yet. He said that he will come back, but he hasn't yet. Still waiting. He hasn't come back. He says, one day I will come back. Yes, I will come back.
He hasn't come back yet. In his lovely Moffitt, little speech.
Moffitt, bring him back. Bring Susan back, please. What do you think of the Sonics he had on his desk?
Well, I really liked the shout out to the classic with his I don't know if you have it around where...
Oh, they're all, I'm not bothering to get
okay
them.
Okay,
maybe in the next next week we'll do
but
that.
But yeah, that was a really nice shout out to the classic era with the old Sonic screwdriver. Of course, like, some of them broke, so, I don't know, maybe he just wanted to reminisce over his Sonic screwdriver. But they were just there in a pot, like...
Yeah. I loved it. I already knew one thing, because I watched the Graham Norton show last night, which was really good, and, you know, that clip with...
where the watery figure materializes. Yeah,
and then the Doctor and Bill go inside the TARDIS. You get this really nice shot of the TARDIS, and then Bill says, "You're not actually. I don't think you're actually sci-fi." And she just turns to him and is like, "I always loved that. I always loved that. Every companion reacting to the TARDIS.
It is." They do it in a very unique way, I must say. Like, it's quite nice.
I liked it when she said it was a kitchen, and...
Yeah.
Also, a little funny. She also said it's a lift as well, which I thought was brilliant.
We should have started playing some lift music.
Yeah.
Oh man. That would be fun.
I really liked the 12th Doctor in. I think we've gotten a bit of Series 8 and a bit of Series 9 Doctor, like more darker and also more light-hearted Doctor.
Yeah, I mean he's obviously all softened up now to a degree. Yeah. Obviously, like, he doesn't want to, you know, originally take her as a companion because it puts a lot of stress on him, and obviously, you know, it will end, and he doesn't want to see the ending. But
what did you think of the Doctor Bill and Noodle going to different points in the universe, like one
they went to the basement, and then they went to Australia, then they went halfway across, well, then they went the whole way across the universe in 23 million years in the future, and then back. I mean, it wasn't that much travelling, but I mean, you know, it's...
What did you think of the Daleks?
I think it was wrong to include them.
I'm sorry,
they are overusing the Daleks now. It was like, I'm just gonna hop into a battle scene with the Daleks. Hey, Dalek, how are you? You know... The Daleks should be these terrifying things, you know.
They're just getting overused for fanfare, aren't they?
Oh man, the decision to use them in pilot was no. I love the Daleks. I love the Daleks. They're basically my favorite enemy. But but it was wrong to use them. Yeah. You didn't feel scared at all. No. It was like, Bill was like, oh, what's that? It's a Dalek. What's a Dalek? It's a Dalek. They were obviously they were first introduced in the new era with the episode Dalek, you know, and just one merited a whole episode about it, and that they're almost impossible to destroy, and all of that. And then you get these, you know, massive, brilliant episodes, but the Daleks are like, very hard to beat creatures. And then you get this episode, which is just like, hi Dalek, bye Dalek.
I just think Steven
That is fan service. Yeah. That is ridiculous.
I just think Steven's just using them just for the sake of it now. And I've just watched the Who Addicts' live stream of them reacting to the episode. If you don't watch the Who Addicts, they're great YouTubers. I've probably mentioned them before. I think I have. But yeah, go and subscribe to them because they're great. They bring great content, and they're basically doing live streams after they've finished the episode. So I really suggest that you should follow them on social media and watch their videos. And they've just said that they're getting a bit annoyed that the Daleks are just being fan service now, but the less that we're seeing them, the more happier they are, because it's Moffat's last story now.
I mean, I didn't see that. I've not seen the video, but you know, the Daleks should be used, but not used in that way.
Yeah.
It is very much being used for fans of it, but the fans want to see something.
Yeah.
And what do you get? You see one Dalek shooting a water blob, and then the water blob has then morphs into a Dalek and has that star thing in its eye, and then it was just like,
This is my one worry about the Mondathian Cybermen at the minute. I mean,
they look actually. No, I know what you're gonna say. You worry that they're gonna just be used for fans.
Yeah,
but I think. I mean, obviously they are used for the fans. They are. Yeah. They are used because. Yeah. You know, but I don't think. I mean, from the trailer, it looks like that they'll actually do something. So I don't think we'll have anything to worry about.
I don't know. But, you know, going back to the first episode of Series 9, The Magician's Apprentice, you know, I remembered everybody being very hyped up about the special weapons Dalek being there.
Oh,
but
don't talk to me about
it. It
that.
Didn't do anything, though.
I liked that we did see it in Asylum of the Daleks, but again, that was
do anything.
We recently watched that one, and Adam pointed out, "Oh, there's the special weapons Dalek," and I was like, "Oh yeah, oh that's cool. Oh, it's not doing anything; it's just looking around, dead or whatever." But
still brilliant in Remembrance. Yeah, Chris Chibnall, please write a good Dalek
that
story.
Was such a good episode. That was such a good episode.
Such a great story. The special weapons Dalek, you just do not want to piss it off.
He either killed two or three Daleks in one, I can't remember.
Yeah, something like that, but it was just, it was badass.
Anyway,
what did you think of the actual story?
Like I said, it was weak.
Yeah.
It was... Oh, look at this puddle. Yes, a strange puddle. Oh, wait, the puddle eats the person because she wants to go away, and then the puddle morphs into the girl with her last memories, so she wants to chase after Bill thinks it's after her. Oh no, the world's in danger because it will travel, it's very fast because it's time traveling and teleporting and etc. And it actually screams and grabs hold and stuff. And then at the end, it turns out to be completely harmless.
Yeah.
It's engine fuel. It's intelligent engine fuel.
Yeah.
What?
I know.
What? It's not. I'm not having it.
As I said, like, you know, it's just the first episode.
I mean, it's not the worst episode.
Oh, no, no.
You know, by all means.
No.
But it's just not. To be fair, the rest of season 10 looks good.
Yeah.
The rest of season 10 looks good.
You know, I know it was a weak storyline, but as I said, like, it's just the first episode of series 10, because, you know, not many first episodes of every series has a great story.
Well, I was going to say Deep Breath. Deep Breath. Yeah. Deep Breath is very good. I really like Deep Breath.
Yeah, the one thing that I just loved about this episode, it was just really fun. Like, I liked it, the whole knowing more about Bill. Like, she was... Because I know some people was like, oh, she's just going to be this whole hyped up companion, going to be excited what she sees. But we just saw, like
the
different versions, really liked.
Yeah. I mean, it was kind of... The only other New Who episode I can think that focuses on the companion as much is Rose.
Yeah.
The first ever episode, but that's introducing the Doctor through a human perspective.
Yeah.
Now that we know
who the Doctor is...
I think it was a bit of an unconventional move, but it was interesting.
Yeah.
You know, we got to see Bill's life, and we got to see what, you know, kind of person she is.
Yeah. Again, the Who Addicts said she's so real. Like, you know, we've just seen, like, her not, like, we've seen, like, she's got a boring old normal human life. But when she meets the Doctor, she's, you know...
Yeah, I mean, but that's what we see for every companion.
Yeah.
I mean, but it's nothing new.
The thing is with Moffat is that what he did with Amy, we didn't really see much of
Amy's
family.
We didn't. They kind of introduced that later.
Yeah, and then that was it. We didn't see
Amy, I think, is the kind of exception for this.
Yeah.
Donna kind of gets introduced, but that's...
Yeah, I think that's but like we didn't really get. But to, we don't get to. We didn't really get to see much of, like Amy or Clara's family that much. But with Russell, he like we knew a we saw a lot of, you know, Rose's family, like with Jackie and Mickey, and we knew about her dad. And I, that's the sort of companion I like, because, you know, it's basically like...
Well, you get to see actually how much it changes them.
Yeah, but that's the thing that Moffat hasn't really done. He hasn't really just, we haven't actually seen much of the companions' proper life, like what they did before. But since since this episode, the pilot, what we saw of Bill, we saw a bit more of her mum, and think it's a girlfriend.
She's not a mum.
This is not a mum. She was going through those.
Oh, the the photographs.
Yeah, we saw a bit more of of that. So I think.
Don't think it was a girlfriend.
No, I'm not sure.
I think it was like
somewhat like that. I can't remember. We need to rewatch it.
Stepmom or something like that.
Yeah, but I think Stephen nailed it on this episode. So that's one thing he was good at.
Yeah, I agree with that. Actually, I agree. It was nice to see a bit about her. I'm still undecided about. About Bill in general.
Yeah.
The character is definitely more cemented in my head than obviously she was before. But, you know, I mean, to be fair, the rest of the series looks pretty good, actually. Good.
we might talk about the trailer another day.
With what?
The last one. The at the end of the episode, that trailer.
Yeah, yeah, that trailer.
We might talk about that another day.
Maybe. Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Although you do get to see... Adam's favourite character, basically.
I have been hyped John Sim. I have been hyped up so much about John Sim. We just saw... Guys... I'm sorry if... None of yous haven't seen the episode yet, so, you know, this will contain spoilers. I should have said that.
It won't contain spoilers at all, really. I don't think it contains spoilers at all.
I mean, like, for those
go ahead, watch the episode. It contains a Series 10 trailer, but that doesn't spoil anything. I mean, they've already released the information. They've already released the fact that John Sim... will be appearing. It doesn't contain any spoilers at all. A trailer for a Series 10, which looks cool.
John Sim.
This guy John is Sim. Cracking.
John Sim is my favourite master.
Oh man. Probably your favourite character.
Oh my. If John Sim is sexy.
Oh dear.
Why would Lucy want to shoot him? He's just too sexy.
Because he didn't like jelly babies.
True. Yeah, he did. He gave some to her.
Did he?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Jelly baby.
All right.
Like master, that's not your reference. So just get that tongue going. It is mine.
Yeah.
But yeah. All in all, I rank this story. 7.5.
I think I might give it a 6.
A 6.
Yeah, I'd give it a 6 out of 10. I may even go 5. Because, I mean, there are loads of episodes that are better. There are loads of episodes that are worse. So I think in terms of, like, if we're relate, if this is an absolute scale, I'd say I'd probably give it a 6. But if this is a scale where I'm comparing it to every one of the other Doctor Who episodes I've seen,
yeah,
I'd give it a 5 because it's about halfway, I think. in terms of a good episode and a bad episode.
Yeah,
so
okay.
I think I'd put it as a 5. Yeah.
Well, the reason why I put it for my 7.5, the story was a bit weak, but I just enjoyed the episode because it was fun. And I think the only reason why I probably liked it the most because, you know, we haven't had Doctor Who for a whole, about bless a year him. And a half.
Bless
it's been so long!
It's okay.
Yeah, I've missed Doctor Who so much. So yeah, guys, that's our review on the pilot. So next week would be...
I've no idea. I've...
Smile.
Oh, smile. Of course. The robots. Okay, you can stop.
So yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Please give us a like and also tell us in the comments what you thought of the episode and what did you like about it and what you didn't like about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So and,
cool.
We shall see you guys next time. I don't have a sonic screwdriver. Bye bye, guys.
Ah, hello. Why not subscribe to Adam Time Lord Fishwick's YouTube channel? It's very good, you know. Goodbye.